The National Alliance's candidate in the Gatundu South by-election, Moses Kuria, will be declared as the new Member of Parliament after the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission received his challenger's official withdrawal notification. And as KTN's Patrick Amimo reports, Kuria told KTN in an exclusive interview that he was quite pleased with the IEBC's verdict that there will be no by-election in Gatundu South.
IEBC commissioners held a crisis meeting at Anniversary Towers to brainstorm on the next course of action after Joachim Kamere of the New Democrats Party officially withdrew his candidature 4 days to the Gatundu South by-election. This left TNS Moses Kuria the only contestant. The Elections Act is not clear on what action should be taken in such circumstances. According to IEBC's communications manager Tabitha Mutemi, the commissioners made reference to the relevant provisions of the law and consulted widely with both internal and external lawyers before arriving at a verdict. Indeed, the commission was at crossroads given that supporters for the two candidates were ready to go to the ballot. After day-long deliberations, IEBC resolved there will be no by-election on Thursday in Gatundu South after Moses Kuria remained the sole candidate. KTN caught up with Kuria to get his response on the decision.
I'm pleased with this verdict. I think it was the right decision, and I think it's a big relief for me and for the people of Gatundu South.
On Monday, Gatundu South returning officer Kipruto Egon was served with a notice from Joachim Kamere indicating that he had withdrawn his candidature. Kamere further returned to IEBC the certificate of nomination as candidate that was issued to him on 10th July. Some critics suggested the electoral law need to be revised to impose severe penalties as a deterrent for individuals and parties who disenfranchise voters by withdrawing at the last minute.
IEBC and myself have saved money, and the country is better off with that. The second thing is that you cannot have a prisoner candidate. Mr. Kamere had stepped down out of his own volition for very good reason. You cannot chain him, handcuff him, and force him to be a candidate.
Should Kuria be declared MP-elect, what would be his development agenda for residents of Gatundu South?
The issue of roads is very high on my priority, and I want to actually do this job within the next 12 months to ensure that all the roads that, you know, that are pending in that particular constituency are finalized. There's the issue of providing water for irrigation. That's another project that is very close to my heart.
Kuria is poised to make history as the first MP to be elected and opposed under a new constitutional order. Some of your critics might say you are so combative, your statements you make are very abrasive. Now that you're going to the National Assembly, what do you expect? Will Moses Kuria change, or will he be this abrasive politician that has been associated with you?
Well, I do not become that way out of my choice. It's because of mischief from the other side. So if they behave, I'll not be, who do I have to be abrasive about? But if they continue with their disinformation, if they continue destabilizing this country, if they continue with things such as referendum and mass action and all that, they'll meet their match.
Well, that is curious word to the opposition. Patrick Amimo, KTN.